Susie, and I'm here to share a devotion on giving. Actually, about the spirit of mammon. I have to be honest with you. Giving was one of the hardest areas I dealt with as I came to know the Lord. My husband and I, early in our marriage, we were a mess. I have to be honest. Physically, emotionally, spiritually, and financially. We had one last chance at our marriage, and that was Jesus. We had both made a decision to go to church together, and that day we got saved. Our lives were never been the same. But one area that I had the hardest time in was giving. And I remember the church we were going to, they were a great church, strong on discipleship. They were training us. Everything was coming into place. Our relationship was growing. Our spiritual life was growing. But one problem, our finances. We could not get it together. I remember my husband saying, "Susie, we have to tithe." And I would say, "I can't, we can't, we can't afford it." And then he started giving me scripture. And I was like, "Stop that. You don't do the finances. I do. We can't afford it." And I remember our church, they were getting ready to do a first fruits offering. And my husband again said, "We have to do that." And I was singing. It was praise and worship time. And I was singing, "I surrender all." And then he had the guts. He bent over. He said, "You don't surrender all." He said, "You're not a tither. And because of that, you worship money." That takes me to my first verse for today. That is in Matthew 6:24. And it says, "No one can serve two masters. Either you will hate the one and love the other, or you will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve both God and money." See, I was raised in a home that taught us money, 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 money. My mom feared not having enough, and I inherited that fear from her. And my husband, on the other hand, he just wanted us to be blessed in every area. And so on the way home from church that day, it was a long, quiet ride home because he doesn't have much to say that's negative, but boy, he put me right in my place. Then he said, "You know, you are worshiping money." And I realized he was right. God had already done all these miracles in our life. And it seemed like every single time we would do two steps forward financially, we'd go four steps back. We could never, ever get ahead. That brings me to the next scripture. "Whoever loves money never has enough." Oh, that was us. And it was my fault. And he reminded me. And it says, "Whoever loves wealth is never satisfied with their income." That was so true. That was alive in my life. I was so worried about not having enough that I had put a curse on our finances. And you know what? That day, we had talked about it. And my husband, he made a stand. And he said, "Susie, I want us to commit not only to our first fruit, but also to tithing." So of course I said, "You know, for the next month, I'm going to tithe." He said, "No, not for the next month, for a year." I said, "For a whole year?" One thing, it was really hard for me, but I said, "Okay, 1 year." Do you know that that was like 28 years ago? And we've never missed the opportunity to give. We are faithful. As soon as we get paid, the first thing I do is I give. The first thing is we tithe. We always do an offering now. I learned my lesson. And every year we do a first fruit. You know, in the Bible, in Proverbs 3, 9 and 10, says, honor the Lord. I remember when my husband said, you're not honoring the Lord. I was so stunned because I love God. I am so thankful for all the miracles He has done in my life. He has done so much. I didn't want to be known as not honoring the Lord. So ever since then, we do what the Bible says. It says, honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruit. So the first thing we do when we get paid, I give. We do it on the app. It's so easy. We give of our first fruit. And it says, then your barns will be filled to overflowing. I'm here to testify. We've never been backwards. We've never gone two steps forward and four steps back again. We have moved forward in our lives and we have been blessed. We have never lacked. We have never gone without. We have been blessed. I'm so thankful to our church that they showed us to give. I remember that I was so thankful because now we do not lack. We do not go without. And God has healed us in every area of our lives. I hope that this helps you to trust God in your giving. God bless you. Thank you.